According to the Quran, Muhammad supposed to be prophesied in the Bible. If Muhammad is not prophesied in the Bible, Quran is a false book, Islam is false religion, Muhammad is false prophet. Here is the Quran. Here is the Quran with the holes in it. It has the holes in it. And I want Muslims to tell me why this book states that Muhammad is prophesied in the Bible. I want Muslims to simply support Allah and back it up. Where is it Muhammad is being prophesied in the Bible?
She has a hole in the Quran and she's saying, like the hole in her head. And
What are you gonna do about? I'm not Muhammad. Muhammad is Satan. Muhammad is Satan. Muhammad is Satan. I am not Muhammad.
You're a dog. You want some attention, we don't give it to you. You're a shaitan.
I am not Muhammad. I am not Muhammad.
And I hope the curse of Allah comes down on you one day.
She just said she's Prophet.
I hope Lord Jesus Christ bless you and shine his face upon you. I pray that Lord Jesus Christ will bring you on repentance to your knees.
Don't speak to her. Don't give her time. She's a devil. She wants to provoke you, kids, yeah? So she can put you on your on videos that she'd look what Muslim is.
Why people come down for the basic question?
You have a hole in the Quran, you're telling me a basic question. What is wrong with you?
Is Muhammad prophet, sir?
You have a hole.
Is Muhammad prophet? Of course, don't answer my question. But my question still stands. My question still stands. And the basic question is, if Quran... Let's look at the Quranic verse.
Okay. You can't read.
Those who follow the messenger, the prophet, the unlettered, whom they find described with them in the Torah and in the Injil, who commands them good conduct and forbids them wrong thing, and permits them of the good things and forbids them harmful things and relieves them of their burden and restriction which were upon them. So those who believe in him and support him and hide him and follow the light which has been sent with him, those are the successful. So according to this verse, Muhammad is described in the Torah and in the Injil. I am asking the basic question, where is it? Muhammad has nothing to do with the Turkish government. I am asking the simple question. Where is this Muhammad in the Bible? Ma'am, are you Muslim? Where is Muhammad in the Bible? So Muhammad is in the Old Testament. Okay. According to this book, according to Quran, okay, it says in the Torah and in the Injil. When Allah says in the Injil, are you telling me that Allah is lying?
No, Allah says in the Injil, it's actually mentioned in the Old Testament.
So, when Allah says in the Injil, Allah gets it wrong, actually it is in the Old Testament. Okay, so Allah fails. Where is it in the Old Testament that Muhammad is being prophesied? Ma'am, where is it in the Torah Muhammad has been prophesied? Where is it in Old Testament? We've got books after books. According to Quran, it is in the Torah. Where is it in the Torah that your prophet is being prophesied?
Jesus is a false prophet. This guy is infecting you.
Up to 11.
You know,
Ma'am, where is your reference? I can't hear you, sorry. That's nothing to do with my question. You told me that Muhammad has been prophesied in the Old Testament. Where is it?
Do you want to come next week?
So you don't have answer for this week?
I don't remember the verses.
You don't know in your mind? Okay, therefore, all I'm going to tell you that Muhammad is prophesied as a false prophet who should put to death. Muhammad is not in the Bible. Now, let me ask you a question that you might know, okay? What's your name, ma'am?
Can we just know this?
What is your name? Okay. Miss Muslim. Why are you Muslim? Can you come a little bit closer so I can hear you?
I said first I was born in a Muslim family, which wasn't the best. But then I researched.
Okay, so that doesn't answer my question. Why are you Muslim?
Because I believe in Allah.
You believe in Allah? Okay, so you believe in Allah and you believe in Muhammad, okay? What is it about Muhammad that you believe?
That he was the final messenger and that he gave a message of mankind.
Explain that to me. I don't believe. So what is your reference that Muhammad is the final messenger while you cannot even produce verse for me from the Bible that's talking about the prophecy of Muhammad?
It's also in the Song of Solomon.
Surah 4, when we're called pigs and apes. What surah is?
Surah 5.
Surah 5, what?
I can get the reference.
They know the
reference.
I know, but they want me to show.
I have to find it. I have to find it.
Surah 5?
I'll check it. Let me check it, brother. Just give me a second. Ma'am, just a moment. Sorry, Surah 7, 166, Surah 2, 65, Surah 5, 60. Yeah.
Surah 7,
apes and pigs. 7, Surah 5, 60, Surah 2, 65, 7, 166. Yes, ma'am. Sorry.
You say to me that why I should believe? Because it's mentioned in the Quran. That's why.
Like you believe. I don't believe in the Quran. Okay. Therefore, I want you to give me proper reference. Why do you believe Muhammad is the prophet of Allah?
Like you read the Bible, and it's mentioned over there. Same similarly, our Quran talks about Prophet Muhammad. So why wouldn't we do?
Just one, sir. He dropped something.
Why wouldn't we do? In our book, it's Muhammad, and it's Jesus, and the other prophets. And in your book, it's Jesus. So you believe in your book, and I believe in my book. So it's a fair deal.
So I find that answer a bit silly. Reason that answer is a bit silly is because your book says so, that doesn't make it true. So my book talks about lots of different people, lots of different individuals and what they have done, and that has been historically backed up. But when it comes to the Quran is a book which cannot even be historically backed up. Let me break it down for you, since you are Miss Muslim. As I read the Islamic teachings, I am very much concerned on what Islam teaches about marriage, about woman, okay? Do you think, is it acceptable in any form or any shape that once your husband divorces you 3 times, for you to reconcile with your husband, you have to go and sleep around with someone, that person is going to divorce you and then you come back to your husband?
Let me tell you the truth behind this.
Yes.
This has become a problem throughout the Muslim world, what you're saying, because they have taken this out of context.
Give me the context. No, so is the verse in the Quran?
No.
Is the verse in the Quran?
Let me finish what you said about halala. You're talking about halala marriage.
Okay, so marriage is called halala marriage.
That is called halala. Unfortunately, this is pulled out of context. The woman was given free up. It was after one divorce, then another divorce. When he divorces a final time, if the husband, the second husband, divorces her according to his own accord, then she can marry. You shouldn't make business out of it. I know people who have made the same mistake that you've talked about. They've made the same mistake. This woman, she married another man just so that she can go back to her first husband. This happened in history, but it's a fault, it's a mistake. People have misused that verse. They have misused it. What should happen if the second husband leaves that woman from his own accord? Then she can marry that first husband. This has been misused.
Okay, Miss Muslim, I thought you were Muslim. I am disappointed that you simply went against the Quran. Can you read the Quranic verse for me? Because Quranic verse doesn't say you get married with someone according to your will, and according to his will, if he divorces you, you go back to your first husband. That's not the Quranic verse says.
Let me read
the Quranic verse and then you break it down for me, okay?
It's misinterpreted.
Okay,
it's misunderstood.
Okay, I am gonna give you time to explain it to me. But am I right to assume, as a bottom line, you think it is very ugly and disturbing for you to reconcile your marriage, you have to have a sex with a stranger to go back to your first marriage? Do you think that's ugly and disgusting?
I don't think that's the rule.
No, that, listen, my question. It is disgusting. Okay,
disgusting, yeah. But that's not the
okay,
rule.
So that's good. Now we identify that's disgusting. Now, let me read the verse and I want you to explain it to me. In case you don't have the Quran with you, I'm going to read it from...
Why is there a hole in your Quran?
Because there are holes in the narrative. I can talk about it in a bit. So, if he divorces her, then she is not lawful for him afterwards, unless she has married someone else and he divorces her as well. So you said, according to her own will, she's marrying, and according to his own will, he's been divorcing. But according to Allah, she's not lawful for him afterwards unless she has married someone else. So that doesn't look like that.
I've read that, sweetheart.
Okay, I'm not sweetheart.
But the thing is, it's been misunderstood.
Okay, explain it to me.
The second husband should leave according to his own will. It's not like make business out of it. Oh, I'm going to marry another husband. Please divorce me. I have to go back. You should not make business out of it.
I am a bit disappointed that you are thinking this as a business.
No, people should not make some sort of, you know, use this as an advantage. They shouldn't use this as an advantage. People have in the past misused this. They have done it. They have done it.
Let me break down my question. It seems it is failing in the translation, okay? Your husband divorced you, okay, three times.
Yeah.
And then he comes to you. This gentleman is going to be your husband for the sake of the argument. He comes to you and then he says, Habibi, I want to reconcile. Here's the flowers and chocolates.
Right.
Are you able to say, yes, let's reconcile?
That was, it's unfair.
No, listen to me.
People have done it.
That's not my question. Listen to my question. You already been divorced third time, okay? He comes to you and then he says, Habibi, here's the flowers, here are the roses, here's the chocolate. Can we reconcile? Are you able to say, yes, Habibi, let's reconcile?
This is misuse of Islam.
That's not my question.
I won't be able
according to Allah. According to Allah, what do you have to do to go back to your husband?
No. According to Allah, no, but the thing is, if I have married someone else, you're saying that, right?
No, you are not married yet. You have been divorced the third time.
And my husband says marry him for the temporary.
No, you are not listening. I know, I can see there is an anger regarding this verse because it is very disturbing and very ugly verse. I agree with you, but you are not listening to my question. You have been divorced the third time, okay?
Yeah.
Your husband comes to you, you are not married yet, okay? Your husband comes to you and then says, Habibi, here's the 12 roses, here's the chocolate from the Belgium, and then look, I got falafel as well, let's reconcile.
Right.
So are you able to say, let's reconcile? What do you have to do to go back to your first husband?
But then I would have to remarry, but...
With whom? With someone else?
Someone
you have to... And then? And then?
It would not be justified if I marry for that sake. It would not be justified. It would mean I'm misusing the verse.
So Allah is lying.
Allah said this.
So you are disagreeing with Allah.
I'm saying Allah said this, but it's been misused. It has not been explained.
Okay, when Allah said, only reason you can go back to your first husband, unless you marry with stranger and that stranger is divorces you, you are saying what Allah said is being misused.
Yeah, people are misusing this verse. That's what I'm saying from the beginning. People are misusing it. I know this is...
So how it needs to work?
This, what should happen is if the second husband, from his own will, divorces her, then she is okay for the first. So if the second husband divorces his wife, right, from his own will, then it's okay. But don't misuse marriage like that. That's unfair.
So Allah is being in here, Allah is being unfair, and Allah is introducing something very disgusting.
People are misusing it.
So in here, it doesn't say woman is marrying according to her will, second husband is divorcing. Listen. Husband is divorcing her according to his own will. In here it simply says, listen to the word I'm emphasizing.
I know what it says.
Why are you disagreeing with the word of Allah? You are not a Muslim.
It's not explained properly.
So word of Allah is not being explained well, even though Allah in the Quran stated word of Allah is well detailed and well explained. That's absolutely fine. So now let me move to the second point. Do you have a problem for your husband to beat you?
That is not allowed. Of course I have a problem.
Okay, you have a problem. So, do you have a problem with Allah when Allah orders husband to beat the wife?
Allah does not order that. This is the fourth option. The first option.
Sorry, does he order or does he doesn't order? Does he order or he doesn't? You said he doesn't order, and now you are telling me this is the fourth option, third option.
The fourth option is to first initiate dialogue, then separate with her. The fourth is to strike her just like this, like a wooden misbah. Not like that, how you say.
So you said, you told me actually it is not option, and you disagree. Now you are telling actually on the third option, husband can do so.
Just that much. It should strike, but it does not mean like beat her violently. Just like with misbah, there is a hadith that explains this.
Can you get the hadith for me?
At the beginning
you said it is not acceptable, and now you are telling me actually now you are telling in the third option it can be practiced, and you are trying to justify that. Okay, so can you get the hadith for me?
Do you have it?
Ma'am, can you get the hadith for me?
Yeah, bro, I just got here.
You know it's
there. Now we are gonna hear half the justification of the beating your wife. We are waiting, lady, to go and get the reference. Let me see where the reference is going to come. Reference is somewhere in the back. We are waiting, lady, to come and then give us the reference. So we are going to hear the justification of the wife beating.
Okay. What is your position? What do you prefer?
Sir, is it okay to beat your wife?
Huh?
Is it okay to beat your wife?
I don't answer. It's okay to beat your wife. She disobeyed you.
No, my mom was beaten by my dad, and it was a lot of pain in my life. So it's not okay.
It's not okay. Okay.
It destroyed the life of the children because I could not understand.
The Quran says it's okay to beat your wife.
No, it shouldn't.
It says
no, they can't say that.
Are you Muslim?
I'm not Muslim.
Good. Can you tell me Muhammad is false prophet?
I don't believe in Muhammad.
He is a false prophet indeed.
I don't believe
in Muhammad. That's done.
I'm just Christian.
So I'm still waiting for the reference. I think lady couldn't, Miss Muslim. Miss Muslim couldn't find the reference, so we give her a little bit chance, because it's always interesting in a sad way to hear the justification of woman who is justifying that how husband should beat her. Now she's googling it. Let's go to the Sheikh Google. In the time of difficulties, in the time of pain, in the time of undefendable, you do have Sheikh Google who always there. Like Max and Spencer.
Because of you, there's a lot of Christian apologists using material from the YouTube.
I personally wouldn't do it, but then again,
actually destroying Muslims.
Not destroying Muslims, but destroying Islam. Because we want Muslims to not be destroyed, so that they will have time to repent and come to Lord Jesus Christ. And if Lord is using us in any form or any shape, all praises goes to Him.
Well done. Anyway.
One of your friends is being expelled from the
party. Why? Sorry, my friend is apparently just being expelled from the party. Let me just... Brother, can you look after my things? I'll be back. Sorry. Brother, what's happening? What is police asking you?
I'm asking you to turn it down, calm down.
Everyone,
turn that,
calm down, wave my hands about.
That's my job, right?
So why are you shouting at me now? I'm just asking what's happening to my brother.
Because I'm saying everyone's in my mask.
You're okay, brother?
Yes.
Okay, don't be dimmy. Don't be dimmy. Not sure actually I'm on that, but... So police asking people to turn down.
To turn down?
Turn down, yes.
What does that mean, turn down?
Turn down. Keep it cool. Don't tell Mohammed.
Okay, calm down. Hey, I think the lady...
We are still waiting for lady to give us the reference.
For some reason.
Looking hot dog. She hasn't found it yet.
Sometimes I do concern the way police engage, especially to the Christians, because they don't want to offend the feelings of Muslims. And therefore, it is not that much surprising. Brother, if you wait here, I'll just make sure my brother is okay there.
They're all victims.
Sorry.
No.
His wife came.
Brother. Come with me. It's okay, come with me. Let's make sure you are okay. Just be around, brother. Thank you. So we are waiting for lady to bring the reference. She wouldn't go. She is proudly defending her prophet. She wouldn't run away.
She did a shamsi.
She wouldn't run away.
She did a shamsi.
She will never run away from her prophet. She was just trying to justify for us the wife beating verses.
She's in a shamsi. She's gone.
She's gone.
She's gone with the wind, but maybe she knows about the wife beating.
It is disappointing that Muslims are running away from the teachings of Allah after Sheikh Google didn't help them. Oh, ladies over there, she might be coming. Ma'am, are you coming, Miss Muslim? No, apparently she's ignoring me. That's absolutely fine. All I wanted to know how a Muslim woman can simply justify that it is all right to beat your wife. But they cannot justify, so all that happens is you walk away. You walk away. Sir, are you Muslim?